I know him.
I've seen everything you've done for the camp. A lot of folks alive because of you. We can fill your bike up if you need it.
Yo, you need fuel?
Okay, man.
I used to be a cop, believe it or not.
All right, check back later, man. See ya.
Yeah, we had it pretty good.
St. John, this is Lost Lake. Come in.
Yeah, Mike. This is Deke.
I heard you tracked down Hart. I was hoping you'd bring him in for trial.
Well, sorry, Mike. Let's say the Swarmers had other ideas about that.
Oh, shit. He didn't tell me that. Hart wasn't the kind of man you ever turned your back to, but he didn't deserve to go out like that.
I guess not. But then I guess Dan Lane didn't deserve to get shot in the back either.
See you, Deke. Hey, Deke, we got a good one.
Hey.
He handed me a shopping list. Said it was a cruiser? Then I should radio you.
Okay, where's Ricky?
Something came up. Anyway, she needs a galvanized metal pipe, tube, kind used in building. She needs a carbon alloy blade, the kind hunters use, and finally some metal scrap. That list make any sense to you?
Yeah, Mike, like you said, I don't ask.
Deacon.
Okay, what do I need? I need a blade or metal tube, scrap. Jesus, Ricky. Metal tube. Can't just be any metal tube, can it? Gotta find one from a construction site.
Wait.
There was a house under construction. Maybe a forest, but I can find something.
Down you go!
Need that. Boozer, you up? This is Deke. Must be sleeping.
Deke? That you?
Shit. Sorry, man. I didn't mean to wake you.
Brother, after working a shovel all day, I pretty much pass out as soon as I hit the bunk. What's going on?
Just checking on you, brother. Just making sure that you didn't wander off on another midnight dance with a whole... Checking on you, brother. Just making sure that you didn't... wander off on another midnight dance with a horde.
Hey, don't worry about me. From the sound of it, you're the one out on a joyride. Hey, I gotta get some shut-eye. Talk later. Out.
I can use these. Always need scrap.
Another micro recorder.
Hey, you see the roster for next week?
Boys. Yeah, what about it? Too low, yeah,
they got our team
camp,
scheduled for pickup,
shots from his 30-yard six.
Really? I missed that. It's not on our route. I don't know, man. I checked with the CO. That's what's on the books.
Damn it. It's not part of my route.
Yeah, no kidding. Me neither.
Whatever. I move you guys around all the time. I've got a specific set of stops I have to make. I've got time-sensitive tests I'm doing. Traps that have to be checked.
Hey, tell it to the CO. I don't make the schedule, and I don't pick the rotations.
Yeah, but I do. Thanks for telling me.
Sure thing. No problem.
Yeah, well, I guess you don't have to worry about your duty roster anymore, do you? Neuro injector, just what the doctor ordered. Ow. Feeling stronger already. Let's see. That should do it. Okay. 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 Oh, Jesus, something went down. Wonder if the poor bastards had anything worth looking for. Let's take a look around. Gotcha.
Damn it, sniper ambush.
He's hiding in these shrubs.
Find him! He's got some heavy shit. No! Look out!
Holy shit!
Let's ambush you, yeah? Let's see what I can do. Good. God damn it. I could fix this.
It should do it.
Come back later to finish burning out these nests. That'll do it. Blade. Where am I gonna find a blade? Wait. Where was that sporting goods store? This is it.
Which way?
Back on track. Nope. Wrong direction. This ought to be enough. Now, I just gotta get all this crap back to Ricky.
Someone's here. Open the gate. It's that drifter.
Yeah, I know him.
So, a couple months ago, we were up by Crazy Willie.
Hey.
Hey.
I got those parts that you were asked for.
Oh, great. Well, check back in a few. I'll see what I can do, yeah?
Ricky. Thanks.
Yeah. Boozer's one of us now.
You here to buy something?
Hey, Buzz. Look out.
I'll be here if you need me.
I think we're out of screw.
See you around.
Got any over there?
Hold on. I'll get it.
Boozer's new prosthetic ready. I asked Addy to find him and send him over.
Great, Ricky. I'll be right there. Deacon out.
Someone's coming. Yeah, it's one of the drifters.
Okay. Crease there.
Okay, got it. Let me secure it in, okay?
There you go, that's better.
Okay.
Hey, brother. Look what Ricky did.
What?
Made me a new toy.
Well, that was all Deacon.
Oh, that's really, really cool, Boozer.
Hey, I could have been one of those three goddamn musketeers. On guard, you fucking ripper.
Pretty cool.
Oh, hey. Jesus.
Maybe this wasn't that good of an idea?
Maybe.
Damn it.
Okay.
St. John, you there? It's O'Brien.
Hold on.
O'Brien, I'm sick of doing your dirty work. You got news for me or not?
Yeah, I mean, yes, I have news.
Well, then what is it?
I need you to do one last job.
Were you listening to what I was just saying? I'm done with this.
One more job, then I'll meet you in person, show you what I got.
Forget it.
Her middle name. It was Irene. Right? Sarah Irene Whitaker. It's on her admission form.
One last job.
One last job. I sent you the coordinates. O'Brien out.
Hey, you're headed somewhere in a hurry?
Yeah. Remember that Nero bastard I told you about, O'Brien? Well, it looks like he's got some news for me, but I gotta do one last job for him first.
Yeah. Okay.
You should come with me.
Yeah? Nah, Skizzle's got me on farm duty. Feeding the world one shitty weed at a time.
Fuck Skiz, I'll drop you off right afterward. When's the last time you saw a helicopter?
I'll tell him he twisted my arm.
Never gets old, does it?
Where are we headed?
Over toward Malakwa Lake. You know where that is?
Yeah, it's just north of the Rogue Tunnel off Waldo Road. So what are we doing there?
A Nero chopper's gonna be on the ground doing whatever the hell it is that they do. O'Brien wants me to see what they're up to.
So O'Brien is what, your shot caller? Handler?
Nope. Loser, you know why the hell we're out here.
Just asking. Seems like he tells you to jump, you ask how high.
It's not how it is. How you holding up?
Not bad. It's been worse, you know. I actually don't mind working the farm, pulling weeds and shit. Reminds me of when I was a kid. I used to go out to my uncle's farm out at by Adrian on the Idaho border. Spend summers working the beet fields. Yeah, a little dirt bike I tool around on. That's where I learned to ride.
If you're not careful, I'm gonna start calling you Farmer Bill. When we get to that site, stay close. Whatever happens, don't let them see you. They can get a little trigger happy.
Okay, got it. Stay down, keep my mouth shut, don't get us killed. Hey, thanks for bringing me along, Pete. It's good to get out again. Even riding bitch, you know?
Yeah.
Okay, stay close. Right behind you.
We need the area secured now.
Yeah.
Let's lock it down.
Okay.
There it is.
Done.
Jesus. Never thought I'd see one of those again. Here, I mean.
All right, now watch. Soldiers come out first. They secure the LZ. Then their boy genius, researcher, scientist, whatever the hell, he comes out. He looks around.
To do what?
Whatever science shit they're doing out here. How the hell would I know?
The one who's been spying on him.
Squad check.
Okay, wait here.
All good here.
All clear.
I heard something.
Back to the bike.
You catch any of that over my radio?
That's pretty fucked up. Good taxpayer money and they're out here collecting freaker shit.
Yeah, I told you. Who knows what they're doing or why?
Oh, they gotta have a base around here somewhere, right? You try following them?
Yeah, but they always disappear over the mountains heading south. And with the highway choked off, I can never get close.
Sons of bitches. Seems like they got a lot to answer for.
Yeah.
Where are we headed now?
It's a good question. O'Brien, are you there? Come in, O'Brien.
I'm here. Finished?
Yeah, it's done. Where am I meeting you?
I wasn't expecting you so soon. I'm sending you the coordinates now, but it might take a few minutes to get there. O'Brien out.
Jesus, what the hell does he think I've been doing out here?
Hey, you're right about one thing. He does sound like an asshole.
Wait here. I don't want him getting skittish because I brought someone along.
Yeah, I'll keep an eye on the bike. I've seen enough Nero assholes for one day.
Okay, I'll be back. O'Brien said he had news. He knew her middle name. Irene. She can't be alive. But he's alive. Why not her, huh? There he is. Yo.
Shit. Gotta stop doing that.
What you got?
All right, look. I'm gonna lay it out for you, but it's not good news. I finally found a guy who was willing to do some digging through some files that they used to keep while they still kept records.
Okay, O'Brien.
Anyway, Sarah Whitaker, your wife, was admitted to the Camp MASH unit on the South Flats outside of Silver Lake. According to the records, she was in surgery for 6 hours and then was moved
okay,
to...
Okay, so she survived. The stab wound, she survived.
Yeah. According to the records, she made a full recovery. And then she was moved to another camp on the outskirts
okay,
of Tumult.
Okay, so she could still be alive. Even after all this time, she could still be alive, you're saying?
No.
What do you mean, no?
It was overrun. Everything was overrun. There were no survivors.
You survived? They survived.
Look, there was nothing that would have protected that camp, okay? Highway 97 is an artery. Infected freaks poured up from L.A., from the Bay Area, from Sacramento. There were thousands and thousands and thousands of them. There was nothing we could do.
I get it. So you bugged out. Who did you bring with you?
Nero personnel, some feds, people with clearance.
Nero personnel? The soldiers? The guys with the guns? The guys who should have been protecting the civilians.
There's nothing that you can do against a horde.
Oh,
they're
no,
too strong.
I know all
they're
about
fast.
Hordes.
Well,
right.
They knew that there was nothing that we could do.
Oh, you know what you could have done? You could have brought a few of them with you. You could have saved a few lives.
There was no hope. There was no time. There was no room. Okay, we'd already turned on each other by the time the hordes arrived.
No, I get it.
I'm sorry about your wife. I'm sorry about all of this. But you gotta understand. If you hadn't sent her with me that night, she would have been dead the next morning. You did the right thing. You know, if you had decided to stay, the only thing that would have happened is you'd be dead right alongside her.
Don't you think I know that? O'Brien. Thank you for saving her life that night.